So now let's talk about object creation. Now when you talk about Java, so Java is purely object oriented, right? So everything around here is an object. Now if you talk about an object, to create an object we require a class. So as we seen in the last or previous video, so to create an object we require a class. So just imagine we have a class here, and now this class, we need to create object of this class. So we have a class in which we have some variables, some methods. So we need to create object of this class. So name of the class is A, okay? So let's create an object of this class. Now if you're familiar with C++, that's how you create an object. So we write A obj, right? But in Java, that obj is not an object, it's a reference. Because in Java, you create object inside heap memory, right? So we have a heap memory here, and in this heap memory, you have to create that object. Now question arises, how to create that object? Now in order to get that object, we have to use a keyword called as new. Okay, so you have to specify new, and then you have to mention how much memory you need. Okay, and that's why we require constructors. So that's A and bracket. So you can see we have A obj, and then that's a reference obj there. Then we have new A bracket. Now that new A bracket, that's a bracket is a constructor. It looks like a method, but it's a constructor. Okay, again, what is constructor? That we'll discuss in detail later. Time will let's focus, we have new A bracket. So that's new A bracket will create an object inside heap memory. Now that object in Java is called as instance. Okay, so whenever you say object, we're actually talking about instance. So we want to create an instance there. Okay, and to create that instance, we have to mention new A bracket, which is a constructor. So A bracket is a constructor. But now let's say in that object, we have two things. We'll be having variables and we'll be having methods, right? Now in order to access those data, so in order to access that variable X, in order to access that method show, we need to create a reference. So that's how we say A obj. So we have A obj equal to new A bracket. So that's how you create an object. So new A, that's an object, and obj is a reference. So in order to call show, we have to use obj.show, because this obj here is directly linked with that object. Now question arises, we get object inside a heap memory, but where is your obj? Now all this reference are called as variables. So variable of two type, basically we have primitive type variables and we have reference type variables. So this obj is a reference type variable. So that's a reference variable, and all this variable will belongs to stack memory. Okay, so we have a stack memory here, and that's our object there. So we have a direct link from this value to that value, but how to provide a link? So let's take an example. Let's say we have int I equal to 5. So that's a variable, right? So they're simple variables. So we have int I equal to 5. Now this variable I will be created inside stack memory. Simple, so we have a stack. In stack we have I. And in the second column, we have to mention the value, which is 5. So whenever I want to access the value of I will simply fetch the value from the stack memory, and the value is 5. Simple. Okay, so in that case, what is the second column for object? It is blank, right? We have to mention something there. That's why we have to mention, so in this heap memory, every object or every instance will have a hash code or some type of code. So we have to pick up that code and we have to assign that code here in the stack. Simple, so let's say that is 101, so that 101 is here. So whenever I say obj.show, your pointer or your reference will be fetching from the stack memory, and it will go to the heap memory. But what happens when you write this line? Now you have obj equal to new A. So we have created that reference only once, but we are initializing that reference two times, in the first line and the second line. Now what happens now is, every time you write new A, it will create a new reference. It will create a new object. Okay, so now we have two objects and one reference. Now since we are using the thing called as equal to, now this value, the new object is 103, so it will replace the value of a stack. So now obj value is 103, not 101. So the old link is bricked, and now we have a new link. Now what happens to the old object? Now this old object is ready for the garbage collection. So in Java we have this amazing concept of garbage collection. Okay, so now that object, which is the previous object, is eligible for garbage collection. Simple. So that's how you create an object and you destroy an object. We have one more way to destroy an object. We can simply say obj equal to null. As soon as you say obj equal to null, it will just break the link and it will assign a value called as null, and then you will be getting now this also is also eligible for garbage collection. So that's how you create an object and that's how you assign the value. Now we will be saying the same thing which we have done in the theory, we'll see in the practical in the next video. So I think this was helpful. So thanks for watching and do subscribe for further videos.